I want to give you some data on A1C. It's a really good predictor of all sorts of diseases. So what is A1C? It's simply a test that gives you feedback on your average blood sugars for 2 to 3 months. And this measurement is something called glycated hemoglobin. Now, what does glycated mean and what does hemoglobin mean? Hemoglobin is the protein in red blood cells. Glycated or glycation is basically glucose sticking to the protein. So when you expose this hemoglobin protein to too much glucose, it becomes glycated. And so the quantity of sugar and protein combining together will raise your A1C. So for example, if you have an A1C of 4, your blood sugars are roughly about 68. If you have an A1C of 5, it's about 97, but typically if it's lower fives, it could be like in the 80s. So higher fives, like 5.8, 5.9, would be like 98. Then you get 6, which is the blood sugar of 126. And if you get 7, you have a blood sugar of roughly about 152. And if it's an 8, it's 183. And it keeps going higher and higher and higher. So A1C is a really good test to tell you what your average blood sugars are. It's much better than a one-time glucose test because it tells you what's happening over a period of time. And so if you're doing really good through the week, yet on the weekends you go off your plan, you eat a lot of sugar, you're not going to probably have good A1C. And so high A1C really is high carbohydrate diet. Now there are many disease processes that occur when you have high A1C. Because the high sugar starts to create a lot of oxidation and problems with all sorts of tissues. But there are four main tissues that high glucose affects. One is a combination of your brain and nervous system. And so we have brain dysfunction, and that could be anything from Alzheimer's to Parkinson's to dementia. There's a whole series of descriptive problems with brain dysfunction. Then you have nerve issues. You have peripheral neuropathies, which occur in the lower extremities, like your feet, and the bottom of your feet become numb, painful, burning. Same thing with your fingertips, right? So what's happening, you're getting oxidation in the circulatory system, which is going to the nervous system, and it's starving off the tiny nerves on the very end part. It's called the peripheral nerves. But there's many other issues you can have. You can have autonomic neuropathy, which the autonomic nervous system is becoming dysfunctional, and that can affect your digestion, your sleep cycles. Then we have the eye. Retinopathy. The retina is the extension of the brain. It's nervous tissue, and that becomes majorly damaged when you expose it with a lot of glucose. But when you have high glucose, you also have cataracts, you have glaucoma, you have many different issues with the lens of the eye. And one big side effect from diabetes is you go blind. Then you're going to have problems with the arteries, the vessels, the coronary artery. It's called endothelial dysfunction. And so you expose the inside of your artery with glucose, you basically rust out the inside, then you have inflammatory processes, you get a clot, you get plaquing, you can get a stroke or a heart attack. So you have brain and nervous system, the eye, the artery, and the kidney, okay? Those are the four main tissues. And with the kidney, the same thing happens. If you expose the kidney with too much sugar, you damage that inside filter because the kidney is a filter. And so you then start leaking out all sorts of things. So you have different stages of kidney disease. Now, there's a couple things I want to mention as far as solving A1C. Yes, you need to cut your carbs down for sure. And yes, you need to reduce the frequency of eating. That's called intermittent fasting. Both of those actions are going to greatly improve your A1C very, very rapidly. But there's something else you can do for the complications of all these diseases. In other words, there's something you can do to reduce the symptoms of exposing glucose to these tissues. You can take B1, but you would want to take it in the form of a fat-soluble vitamin called benfotiamine. You see, what happens is this high level of glucose depletes vitamin B1, which is essential for the metabolism and breakdown of the sugar. And so as you have high levels of sugar, you deplete your B1 and you get a lot of complications, including more glycation, more oxidants, more free radical damage. So if you're a diabetic, if you're a pre-diabetic, I would highly recommend, in addition to reducing your carbs and doing intermittent fasting, also take some benfotiamine. I would take probably 4 pills per day, and you're going to see amazing results with your symptoms. You may even still be a diabetic, but you'll have a lot less symptoms. You're going to notice your vision is going to be better, less complications with peripheral neuropathy, less issues with your kidney, better focus, and better cardiovascular function. Now, if you haven't seen my other videos on B1 and benfotiamine, I put a link down below. Check it out.
Hey, before you go, if you're benefiting from any of my content, I would love to hear about your success story. Please share it in the link down below.